The past. There is a place few long to go, a place of vain regret, a place of painful consequence, of tearfulness, and yet it seems so many linger there, absorbing hurts long past, destroying peace God longs to give, if all on Him were cast. The burden of past promises that others did not keep, the worries over little things that kept us from our sleep, the guilt of knowing other hearts were broken in the wake of things we did or said to them, or time we did not take, to share what God had given us in time and tender ear, to listen with attentive mind and heart that we might hear the burdens and the special joys that they so longed to share, if they could simply find someone who really, truly cared. Enough to set themselves aside and focus on the need of one for whom our Savior died and for whom Christ did bleed, that none should have to wander in the place we call the past, but could by grace through living faith appreciate the fast that draws us from the pressures of this world that we live in, and gives us strength and confidence to overcome all sin, as daily with God's word in hand we spend our time with Him, and pray with constant fervency to be His light to men, releasing painful memories of things we once had done, the things that caused the love of God to sacrifice His Son, that we might be forgiven and released of all our sins, if we would by His Spirit choose to be the more like Him. For nothing can we do or say can change what made the past, but everything we do and say can help another cast their soul in hopeful confidence upon the God that's true, who only shows us perfect love and what He leads us through. That we might, like our Savior, understand the needs of men who long to have a freedom from the consequence of sin, and know they have acceptance with our great Creator God, who likewise walked like other men and suffered on this sod. So if you have not done so yet, please take God at His word, and know as you embrace His love your every prayer is heard, and know as you release the past you have no power to change, like every soul who trusts in God, eternal life you'll gain. For reference, Romans 7:18-25 and 8:1-4.